Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's Laszlo Montgomery here, back again with the seventh installment of the sixth season of the Chinese Sayings podcast. Glad you could make it. Another good one today, another quickie, with both a 4- and 8-character version. Like the golden oldie from the very first season of the Chinese Sayings podcast, Qian Li Song E Mao, there's a short version and a long version. But if you utter the first part only, that'll do the trick. The short version for today's Chengyu is 塞翁失马. And if you want to add the second part, you follow it up with 4 more characters, 焉知非福. And with all that said, let's put this one under the microscope. 塞翁失马. 塞, that's a place of strategic importance, a fortification, or the frontiers of the Chinese Empire that was always prone to attacks from nomadic tribesmen. Wēng is an old man, but is used in a courteous or respectful manner. Some of you may recall Lü Wēng from the Season 5 closer, Huang Liang Mei Meng, Old Man Lü. Shi means to lose, and Ma, once again, is a horse, not a deer. 塞翁失马, frontier old man lose horse. Who knows what that means? Let's see if the back 4 characters shine any light on this. 焉知非福. Yen is a pronoun used in classical Chinese, meaning here or this, and in rhetorical questions it means how. Zhi means to know, and fei means wrong or a wrongdoing. Fu is one of the most important Chinese characters. A lot of people wear jewelry with this character on it, or they hang it in their house upside down on the outside of their door. It means good fortune or blessings. It's also a tattoo favorite. So, the frontier old man lose horse. In what respect no is not a blessing? Well, let's not hit the buzzer yet. I already kind of tipped you off, but before you go blurt out the answer, let's hearken back to the good old days of the Western Han Dynasty and open up the ancient classic book, the Huananzi, to the chapter entitled Ren Jian Xun, The Duke of Huainan, Lessons from the People. The Huananzi was a work containing a bunch of scholarly debates carried out at the residence of the Prince of Huainan that sought to argue the best possible ways to order society and what makes the perfect ruler. The Huananzi is heavily influenced by Taoist philosophy and also contains Confucian overtones. So let's dive right in and listen to the story behind this one. It's a short one. Living in a frontier town of the Chinese Empire was an old man who was skilled in divination and fortune-telling. One day, this elderly gentleman's horse wandered outside the borders of China into the territory of the nomadic tribesmen who often mounted attacks on Chinese towns. This was no small thing, for horses were like your car, your tractor, and it was a critical part of your household and well-being. Wandering into enemy territory like it did meant the old guy couldn't dare go look for it. So everyone gave the horse up for lost, and some came to offer their sympathies to the old man to comfort him for his loss. But the old man said this to the well-wishers, "How do you know that this matter might not turn out to be a stroke of good fortune?" Well, that gave everyone pause to wonder, and some no doubt appreciated the old man's positive mental attitude. After some months, to everyone's surprise, the old man's horse returned. And not only did his horse return, but accompanying it was another very fine horse who had most likely once belonged to some tribesman of the steppe. Now, seeing the old man's good fortune, everyone came to offer him their heartiest congratulations. Yet the old man said to his visitors, "How do you know that this whole thing might not end badly? Why are you so sure this is a stroke of good luck?" The people considered what he said and thought, well, perhaps. Now that the old man had 2 good horses, not only he, but his only son as well. They could both go out riding together. But one day, on one of these trips, something spooked the horse ridden by his son, and it rose up in fear, throwing the son from his mount. And the son broke his leg from the terrible fall, and such was the injury he suffered. Never again could he walk normally, and his leg never fully recovered. All the local townsfolk heard about this and came to offer their sympathies and tried to comfort the old man on this misfortune that befell his son. As they uttered their kind words and sought to make him feel better, they found him utterly unconcerned and, in fact, calm and smiling as if this was all nothing. He went on to say, "How do you know this broken leg might not be a blessing in disguise?" Once again, the people silently wondered about these words he had spoken. About a year later, the nomadic tribes from the north launched a full-scale invasion of the Chinese border towns. As was the common thing to do back then, every able-bodied young man was called upon to take up arms and defend Chinese territory. But such was the ferocity of the nomad invasion that, out of every 10 Chinese men who went out to meet them in battle, 9 did not return. Of course, the old man's only son, with his bad leg, had not been able to fight in the war. And for this reason, when the old man became feeble and infirm in his last years, he still had a son to take care of him for the rest of his days. So from the story behind this Chinese saying of this old man, "Sai Wang Shir Ma," we can see what might seem like good or ill fortune might actually turn out to be just the opposite. And what seems unlucky might in fact be fortuitous. In the Huananzi, it's written, "Hua bu ke ji, shen bu ke ci ye." The changes of life are innumerable, and their depths are beyond human prediction. So this Chengyu gets trotted out anytime you hear someone so accepting of their ill or good fortune. You never know if something that appears to be a setback or a disaster later on turns out to be one of the best things that ever happened to you. Sai Wang Shir Ma, Yen Zhi Fei Fu. An old man loses his horse. How do you know this isn't a blessing? But all you have to say is the front four. Sai Wang Shir Ma. That's what you use whenever you want to say that something might be, or indeed was, a blessing in disguise. Sai Wang Shir Ma, Yen Zhi Fei Fu. Or, if that's too much of a mouthful, Sai Wang Shir Ma will suffice in expressing your belief that something might be or ended up being a blessing in disguise. And there you have it, our 7th Chinese saying of the season. 3 more to go. Once again, sending out a big thanks to Emma, no longer residing in the UK, back in China, studying in the national capital in Beijing. She's scouting out locations as we speak to serve as the new headquarters of the Teacup Chengyu Yanjiu Zhongxin. She'll have that set up and in operation by the next episode, I'm sure. Thanks a bunch, Emma. This is Laszlo Montgomery signing off from L.A., California, as always, wishing you a fine farewell and tempting you to come back next time for another useful and interesting Chengyu here at the Chinese Sayings Podcast.